Detachment from attachments is the only way to enlightenment. Because enlightenment means the complete detachment from all attachments. Attachment means a bondage, mental bondage. You are bound to what you are attached to mentally. That means your freedom is restricted. You may get attached to your wife or husband. That is a bondage. You may get attached to your son or daughter, or brothers and sisters, or parents. You may get attached even to the Buddha, or even to the enlightenment, the bliss of enlightenment. That itself is a bondage. Even the Buddha was attached to enlightenment before he got enlightened. That is why he underwent torturous difficulties to be enlightened for nearly 7 years before his enlightenment. Because he had a strong will. Strong will means strong desire to be enlightened, without knowing really what enlightenment is. It is only at the real enlightenment that he realized what enlightenment means. That is why in his first discourse, the maiden discourse called Dhammacakkappavattana Sutta, he said, that the only path to enlightenment is a middle path free from attachment to sensual pleasures and the resentment of pains. Or it may be you get attached to your own pains, expecting something that you desire. For example, for nearly 7 years, as I mentioned earlier, Buddha underwent torturous difficulties with the idea of getting enlightened, thinking according to his teachers that the only way to be enlightened is to suffer the body with pains. Starving, that is a suffering for the body. Painting, drinking and eating, at least for a period. There is a torturing of the body. Not sleeping. There is also torture in the body. Leading a secluded life away from others. There is also a self-torture. Buddha said in his first sermon, the path to enlightenment is a middle path. Middle path means between attachment and resentment. a state of mind free from attachment and resentment. That is, free from likes and dislikes. When we like something or some event or somebody, we are attached to what we are like because we are not happy until we get what we like. That means our happiness is not independent. It is dependent. You may depend on your wife or husband because you are attached. Attachment means you expect the wife to behave in a certain way or the husband to behave in a certain way. Or you like the way he or she behaves. And if he or she behaves in a different way that you don't like, you suffer mentally. Therefore, our happiness, until we are independent by enlightenment, we are depending on others, other beings, other things, other events. Unless we get, or unless the beings that we get behave in the way like, unless the things we get are in the way that we like, unless the events that take place are not in the way we like, we are unhappy. That means attachment to anything, any being, any event is an impediment on our mental bliss. That means our mental bliss called happiness is not independent but dependent. That is a mental bondage. We have inborn inner tendency in us both for negative and positive attachment. We like something that is attachment. We dislike something means that is resentment. But it is a negative attachment. We are attached to things that are in the way we like, and we don't want things to be in the way that we do not like. That is a negative attachment. Negative attachment which we resent or we dislike. Certain things, certain beings, certain events, because we like them to be in a certain way that we like. Therefore, both our likes and dislikes are bondages. Practically, in our day-to-day life, in our normal life, we have to entertain likes and dislikes. We have to get what we like and we have to get rid of what we dislike if we are to lead a happy life. That means our happiness in life is not independent but dependent. Enlightenment means a completely independent life that is blissful, and that bliss is not dependent on anything. That means An enlightened mind can accept things as they are. That means the enlightenment mind has realized things as they are, or see things as they are. That is their way. That is understanding things as they are. In Buddha's language, seeing things as they are is called Yatha Bhuta Jnana Dasana. Seeing things as they are, that is their nature, that is their way. And your ability to accept things as they are is called Yatha Labha Santutti. That means your inner bliss is not dependent on anything outside. There is an inner bliss. The bliss that is dependent on outside elements, animate or inanimate or incident, is called in Buddha's language Samisa Sukha. Bliss of mind dependent on external objects, events, beings, things, etc. The bliss that the enlightened ones experience is not dependent on anything outside. It is an inner bliss. That bliss is the complete extinction of all attachments. When you are not attached to anything, any being or any event, you can accept anything, any being or any event as it is, as they are. The inner bliss is not disturbed by external objects. That is why Buddha said in his discourse called Mahamangala Sutta, Puttasa Loka Dhammehi Chittangasana Kampati, with regard to enlightened mind. The enlightened mind, according to the statement there, is not disturbed, not perturbed, not troubled, not disturbed by external events, things and beings. A mind that can accept the world, the society, the environment, and even your own life, your body, your health, or your old age, or your sickness, or your pains, as they are. Because the inner bliss of an enlightened one is not disturbed by anything outside, by the worldly nature, Loka Dhamma. That is what is meant by Puttasa Loka Dhammehi Chittang Yasya Nakampati. Therefore, the real bliss, the eternal bliss, called Nirvana in Sanskrit, Nibbana in Pali, the supreme bliss, is the bliss of non-attachment. But in our normal life, day-to-day life, the bliss of mind that we call our happiness is dependent on the outside elements, outside things, outside beings, outside events that are in the way that we like. But if they are not in the way we like, our happiness turns into unhappiness. That means our happiness is not independent. Is dependent. The path to enlightenment as well as enlightenment can be called an independent path, an independent state. On the path to enlightenment, one practices to be free from attachment. All our attachments are past-oriented, according to certain tendencies in our body and mind. We get attached to things, beings, and events according to our inner tendencies. That is why one's meat becomes another's poison. What one likes may not be liked by all others. Different people have different tastes. Different beings have different tastes. Therefore, one can be happy only when things, beings, and events are in the way of his taste or her taste, what he likes. That is, as I mentioned, a restriction on our mental freedom. Our mind is not free. Freedom is the basis of enlightenment. Complete freedom is the outcome of enlightenment. And also, freedom, emancipation, is the path to enlightenment. That means when you practice the path to enlightenment, you train your mind to accept things as they are, free of likes and dislikes, free of prejudices. We are bound to our likes and dislikes. We are bound to our prejudices. We are bound to our opinions. We are bound to our religions. We are bound to our wives or husbands. We are bound to our children. We are bound to our parents, relatives, friends. We are bound to the society. We are unhappy when what we are bound to are not in the way that we like. That means our happiness is dependent, not independent. Attachment is always a mental bondage. But in our day-to-day life, for material happiness, we need things that we like. We have to get rid of or remove things that we dislike. But in the spiritual life, our happiness is not dependent on things that we like or dislike, because our mind is free from likes and dislikes. Not only an enlightened mind, but also a mind in the process of getting enlightened is free from likes and dislikes. The Buddhist meditation, known as the path to enlightenment or taking of enlightenment, is to accept things as they are without liking and disliking. Normally, the Buddhist meditation, according to the practice of majority of Buddhists, start with a meditation called Anapanasatiya. Buddhist meditation is not concentration, but it is a choiceless awareness. That means, choice means you choose things that you like out of the things that you dislike. That means, choice means removing or discarding things that we dislike and getting hold of things that we like. According to Krishnamurti, the path to enlightenment is referred to as choiceless awareness. Buddha referred to it as sati sampajanya, wise awareness. What is wisdom? Accepting things as they are without likes and dislikes. A mind free from prejudices. For that one has to see things as they are. That is why Buddha said in a discourse called Karanimi Sutra, Dittincha Anupagamma Silava Dasanena Samponno. To get enlightened, you have to see things without prejudices. Dittincha Anupagamma Silava. That means it is only a scientific attitude to things. Scientific attitude means an attitude free from likes and dislikes, free from prejudices. That means mind not attached to anything. It's the way to enlightenment and is also the way of the enlightened mind. Enlightened mind behaves without prejudices, without likes and dislikes. And the mind on the path to enlightenment also get trained, practices to lead the life free from likes and dislikes. That's the spiritual path. But to live in the material world, we have to get things that we like and get rid of things that we dislike. That is a practical life. But once you become wiser, you realize that even getting what you like will not make you happy forever. That happiness is temporary. Because worldly nature is that it makes us to face not only things that we like, but also to see things that we dislike. Therefore, practically, to lead a life free from tension, free from anxiety, free from stress, free from worries and suffering, we have to train our mind to accept things as they are. And that is helpful to extend in our material day-to-day life. It is really meant as a means of our enlightened path. If you aim at being enlightened, you have to get detached from all your attachment one by one, as said in the Dhammapada Malavagga, Toka Tokam Kane Kane. It has happened little by little from moment to moment. Because our attachments are innumerable. Because we have tendencies for attachment that we have created in all our past lives. In number of discourses, say, even he himself, through his enlightened vision, could not see the beginning of his existence in this universe, in this existence. His words are, anamataggo ayan sansaro. The existence has no beginning, because you see. That means, for such a long period, from life after life, we have created tendencies of prejudices to like or dislike certain things, beings and events. And we have to face them gradually. We have to get rid of them only when they crop up. They crop up moment to moment. Therefore, we have to get rid of them moment to moment. Get detached from those attachments. We are attached to both our likes and dislikes. Attached means we are motivated by our likes, motivated by our dislikes. We are directed in our activities by our likes and dislikes. We have become slaves to our likes and dislikes. Enlightenment means freedom from that slavery. That is why the Buddha said in a sutta called Paharada Sutta that you get in the Anguttara Nikaya, we have to practice the path to enlightenment in a graduated process, step by step. Anupubha kriya or anupubha sikha, discipline. One discipline, another thing to discipline, step by step. It's a step by step path. Therefore, in our day-to-day life, we have to get rid of our attachments gradually, practically. That means you need not give up your attachment all of a sudden, everything. Your attachment to wife or husband, you have to continue with it. Because if you want to get enlightened, leaving your wife or children, or relatives or friends away, that means a selfish attachment. You try to get rid of one attachment through another attachment. Unless you get detached from your attachment to enlightenment, you can never become enlightened. Therefore, first of all, if you are interested in getting enlightened, don't get attached to enlightenment, because that itself is a bondage. There is a loss of freedom. Don't get attached even to the Buddha's teaching or to the Buddha. Finally, that does not mean that you have to listen to the Buddha's words, practice the path said by the Buddha. But we have to do that wisely. You may be able to digest only a bit from all what Buddha has uttered. You may be able to practice only a bit of all what Buddha has directed. Be satisfied at the moment and try to minimize your attachment as far as possible. Lesser the attachment you have, greater the freedom you have, and higher the bliss of mind you can experience. that you can find out yourself by your own experience. Not following what the Buddha has said or what some other scholar has said. Buddhism is a path that you have to travel with a self-conviction, with a self-realization. In the stage you are, you may not be able to digest the entire teaching of the Buddha. You may not be able to follow the entire discipline laid down by the Buddha. Therefore, don't get attached to Buddha's teaching or to the discipline he has laid down. Make use of your intelligence, your wisdom, and without attachment to the Buddha's teaching or the Buddha's discipline that he has laid down, practice Buddhism moderately according to your capacity. And that capacity will grow gradually, step by step, little by little. It is only then your attachment to things, beings and events get little by little diminish, and they will become completely extinct at the enlightenment. Enlightenment means freedom from all attachment. The root cause of attachment, according to Buddha's words, is called tanha, thirst for happiness. We do everything because we have a thirst for happiness. Get rid of that very thirst for happiness means enlightenment. That's called tanhakaya in Buddha's language. Tanhakaya means detachment from all attachment. At the very root of attachment, the root of attachment the Buddha referred to is tanha, that every being has an inborn desire, inborn thirst for happiness. Even the very attachment to happiness is an impediment to enlightenment. One can be really enlightened when one is detached from the attachment to the bliss of enlightenment, that you can realize by yourself through your own experience. If you are wise, intelligent, and sensitive enough to your own mind and body,